Now students, in this lecture we will learn that what is a Rankine cycle. Okay, Rankine cycle is an external combustion engine. Okay, and why it is called as external combustion engine I will tell you later. In fact, it is a sort of engine in which heat converts into work. Okay, and the working substance in the Rankine cycle, because we know this thing that when there is an engine, then there is also a working substance associated with it. Okay, so the working substance in Rankine cycle is vapor. Okay, so it is also called as vapor power cycle. Vapor develops the work in the cycle like this. Okay, so how it develops the work I will tell you later. Over here you learn this thing that the Rankine cycle is an external combustion engine, also called as vapor power cycle, whose job is to convert heat energy into work. Before understanding this lecture, you must have the adequate knowledge of TS diagram of water, that is a temperature entropy diagram. In case you don't know that, then you must watch my that lecture, which is devoted especially to learn the TS diagram of water. Okay, by now let's learn that what Rankine cycle is. See, Rankine cycle is an external combustion engine in which high energy steam is developed in a boiler. Okay, means in the boiler the liquid enters, and generally the liquid is water. So water enters in the boiler, and by addition of heat to it, it converts into high energy steam. Okay, the high energy steam so developed is passed through a turbine to develop power. Okay, so that high energy steam is passed through a turbine, and the job of the turbine is to transform the energy content of steam into mechanical work. That's it. The exit steam from the turbine is then passed through a condenser to convert it into liquid water. Means after doing work in the turbine, the steam which is coming out from the turbine is passed through a condenser, and that vapor is again changed into liquid water. Okay, the liquid water is sent back by the help of a pump to the boiler for generation of steam. Means the liquid water so collected after condensation, whatever the amount of liquid water is coming out from the condenser, it is taken by the help of a pump and then again fed to the boiler. So by this way, in these four steps, the entire cycle completes. Okay, so high energy steam is developed in the boiler, it is passed through the turbine to develop power, mechanical work. Okay, after passing through the turbine, ultimately the steam is passed through the condenser to convert back into liquid water, and that liquid water by the help of pump is sent to the boiler back so that the cycle can complete. Okay, so over here by the help of arrow I am showing, this is the physical diagram of Rankine cycle. This is the boiler. Okay, so suppose from point 4 the liquid water is entering inside the boiler. Okay, so it is converting into high energy steam. That steam is passed through a turbine between 1 and 2. So by this way, heat converts into work over the shaft of the turbine. Okay, so this between 1 and 2, this is adiabatic expansion of steam. Okay, in the turbine the steam expands and develops work. After coming out from the turbine, it is sent to the condenser. Through the condenser, it rejects heat and becomes liquid water again. That liquid water is taken by a pump and again fed back to the boiler with desired pressure. Remember this thing, that this is a steady flow process. Means everywhere the mass flow rate is constant. Okay, so we are studying this concept when there is steady flow. Everywhere the mass flow rate of steam is same. So when the liquid water comes out at point 3, then by the help of the pump it is fed to the boiler from point 4. So water enters inside the boiler from point 4 and ultimately comes out from point 1 like this. Okay, remember, in the boiler constant pressure steam generation takes place. Okay, whatever the desired high pressure inside the boiler is, at that pressure the steam generation takes place. From beginning to end the pressure remains constant. So why the Rankine cycle is called as external combustion engine? Because internal combustion engine is the one in which heat is always generated inside the system. For example, an IC engine, okay, 4-stroke SI engine, in which heat is developed inside the cylinder. But in this case what happens, heat is supplied from outside agency, okay, by burning coal or any other fuel. It could be coal fired, it could be oil fired, or any other fuel we are burning. The heat could be supplied by nuclear reaction also. In that case it becomes a nuclear reactor like this. Okay, so heat is supplied from outside and that heat is converting into work. This is the reason that Rankine cycle is called as external combustion engine. Combustion doesn't take place inside the system, the combustion happens outside, and heat is supplied from outside to inside of this system. Now we will learn that how to draw the Rankine cycle in TS diagram, temperature entropy diagram. This is the dome. Inside the dome the condition of water is liquid plus vapor. To the left hand side it is liquid, to the right hand side it is vapor. Okay, now suppose water enters at point 4 in the boiler. You can see at point 4, now when heat is added in the boiler, so first of all the boiling point will reach, this is the saturation temperature, the boiling point of water. At boiling point, it will absorb the latent heat. Okay, this is the phase change process. Then it will be superheated in the boiler. You can see up to 0.1, it is superheating. Okay, then at 0.1, it is entering inside the turbine. So what happens inside the turbine? It is isentropic expansion. You can see this expansion is taking place. Okay, so temperature is decreasing, but entropy is not changing. Entropy remains constant. Okay, the reason being that we know this thing, entropy change dS is given by del Q by T. Okay, so del Q is the amount of heat added. So what happens that in the turbine, neither heat is added nor heat is removed. So del Q remains zero. So inside the turbine, ideally, the expansion is isentropic. The temperature falls as well as pressure also falls, but its expansion remains isentropic. Okay, at 0.2, it is coming out from the turbine. Okay, and entering inside the condenser. So what happens in the condenser? It rejects latent heat of vaporization, you can see, and ultimately converts into liquid back. At 0.2, it is in form of vapor, and ultimately by rejecting latent heat, it is becoming liquid at 0.3. Okay, and from 0.3, the pump is picking up the water coming out from the condenser and then forcing it to go inside the boiler. So this 3-4 is the pump work, WP. Okay, 1-2 process is WT, it is the turbine work which is obtained by the cycle, and WP is the pump work which is fed between 0.3 and 0.4. So like this way the cycle completes, and it is shown in the TS diagram. Remember this thing, that this diagram is not scaled, it is just indicative diagram. Okay, so once again, 1-2-2 is the isentropic expansion in the turbine, work is developed. 2-2-3, heat rejection in the condenser, the steam which is coming out from the turbine is converting back into liquid. 3-2-4, the pump is taking the liquid water from 0.3, and from 0.4, it is going inside the boiler. And 4-1, heat addition in the boiler. Heat addition in the boiler can be taken as Q1, and heat rejection in the condenser can be taken as Q2. Okay, WP is the work input to the pump, because pump will absorb energy to make the liquid water to flow toward the high pressure boiler. In the condenser, the pressure is low. In the boiler, the pressure is high. So forcing the water to move from low pressure condenser to high pressure boiler, it needs some work. So pump absorbs work while the turbine gives work like this. Okay. Now what would be the efficiency of this Rankine cycle? Very simple. It is equal to the net amount of work gained by the Rankine cycle upon the input. We always think that net input is the heat input between 0.4 and 1. Okay, so we can name it as Q. However here it is Q1, we can name it as Q also. Okay, so Q is the amount of heat which is input to the cycle between 0.4 and 1. Now what is the net work? Since in the turbine we gain work, so that is WT, but in the pump we have to input work. So net work is what? The difference of the two. So WT minus WP is the net work gain. Okay, and we know this thing, that the amount of energy transformations between any two points can be given by the enthalpy differences over those points. For example, suppose over here the enthalpy of steam is H1, and over here enthalpy of steam is H2, and obviously it would be lower than H1. So H1 minus H2 is what? Is the amount of work developed in the turbine. Because if H2 is lower than H1, then where the energy has gone? Since we are not considering any sort of losses, so whatever the difference is there between H1 and H2, that is what the turbine work. Similarly, H4 is the enthalpy at 0.4 and H3 is at 0.3. So pump is actually adding energy, because energy input takes place in the pump. So H4 is greater than H3. So H4 minus H3, the energy difference of steam between these two points will give the net pump work input. So in place of WP, we can write H4 minus H3. Similarly, what is Q? The amount of heat added, that is equal to the H1 enthalpy at 0.1 minus H4, because water enters from 0.4 in the boiler and comes out from 0.1. So enthalpy difference between 0.1 and 4 will give the efficiency of the cycle. Okay, net work output upon the input, because the general definition, the universal definition of efficiency is the desired effect upon input. So desired effect is what? The work gained from the cycle, and input is the heat to the cycle. Now generally the amount of pump work is very low compared to that of work developed in the turbine. Okay, so H4 minus H3 is generally negligible compared to that of H1 minus H2. So we can disregard this. In case we want to neglect the pump work, H4 minus H3, then the efficiency can be approximately equals to H1 minus H2, that is the work developed in the turbine upon H1 minus H4, that is the heat input in the boiler. So this is what Rankine cycle is. By this small lecture, you would have understood what Rankine cycle is, what is the physical diagram of Rankine cycle, and what is the TS diagram of Rankine cycle. Thank you.